righteousness to descend is for you to acquire through obedience to the law. Who are you? By what authority do you baptize for forgiveness of sins?
We have been sent here by the authorities in Jerusalem. My name is Nicodemus, and I'm from Bethany. This man is...
I'm from Arimathea, Joseph. Where do you come from? By what authority do you supersede the law?
You viper's brood!
What?
Who warned you to flee from the wrath to come?
There is no wrath for God's chosen.
Do not suppose you can say to yourself, we have Abraham for our father, for God is able to raise up children for Abraham from these stones. The axe is already laid at the root of the tree. And every tree that does not bear its good fruit is cut down and thrown into the fire. Come on, who's next to go into the river?
Well, we can return to the council. We need no more evidence.
Joseph, wait.
We learned all we need to know.
We know nothing. Who is this man? Does it not impress you that Hakob your deer has fallen into this river, preparing for the arrival of a kingdom, a king, a prophet? I don't know. Something larger than us.
There is nothing larger than us. We represent the law.
What if this is the fulfillment of the law? What if he is the Messiah?
What?
I want us to find out more.
Oh, you never change, do you? Always taking a step back, analyzing. What if the things that never materialized, like itinerant messiahs that wander along the rivers?
No, things never change, and you never stop rushing to judgment.
At least I make judgments.
No one has that right except Jehovah. I want to find out more. You, the baptizer, who are you? Are you a prophet? Like a prophet? No. What do you tell me about yourself that I make an answer for those who are sinners? Who are you?
Thank you.
baptized by you, and yet you come to me.
Searching the law. Yet I have no explanation for what I have seen. This man did not seem to be the Messiah that I had sought. But how do I know I'm even looking in the right places anymore?
The time is drawing short.
Can't help but feel I'm running out of time.
There are a great many decisions to be made for the days ahead.
I need some time to reflect, to think this thing through.
I need to speak with my wife.
I'll return to my sisters. It's time I went.
Well, decide it.
Home.
Home.
I hadn't begun to work. You're so late coming home from this journey.
I would never mess the Passover meal here. You know that.
Yes, I know that.
Now the truth, Ruma. How are you feeling? Has the stiffness returned?
My brother, the interrogator, even on Passover, you're a fussier old woman than I am. You're 5 years younger. Now, I lived without my husband Eden, may Jehovah preserve him, for 10 years, and I'll manage perfectly well for the next 10.
You've managed for both of us. I often wonder where I would have gone to after Ruth, after Sarah and Samuel had died. Seems I lost more than my wife and son to that epidemic. After praying for months for a healing, for an end to suffering, in silence from the one you spent your life serving. You lose your sense of direction. But I have always turned here, and you always have the second chair at the table for me, haven't you?
What is it, Nicodemus? What did you see in the mirror?
I saw hope. Yeah, there were hundreds of despairing people walking into some water, and emerging as if they'd been reborn. And then this man walked into the room, and I don't know if I was blinded by the sun or deafened by the water. I think I saw a light, and I heard a voice. Maybe it was, I don't know.
But tell me.
So there were two false prophets instead of the one reported. Well, I'm certain you discredited and dismissed them as quickly as you've done the others.
No. One of them will not be quieter than the other, or the other cannot be dismissed.
What are you saying? That you're going to allow these charlatans to further divide our people? We've already been reduced to servants and children by the Romans. If we commit to this destruction from within, the nation will perish.
Well, the nation will never perish. God will see to that. And so will I.
By upholding the law.
By making the people uphold the law. By forcing them to face their unrighteousness.
You're sounding like your father again.
I am not my father.
No, that's true. You would never for once believe that you could be your father, that you could achieve his stature, real or imagined. The man whose crowning legacy left his son was a new stone tomb.
That tomb is a tremendous honor for my family. It represents the extent of my father's position and achievement in this world. I can can only hope that we can prove ourselves worthy to be buried there.
He's been gone 8 years, and you are still trying to gain his approval.
He was a righteous man. If more people had followed what he had said, if I had approval,
then Judea would be preserved.
Yes, quite possibly. Leah, I don't understand this. I thought you loved the law as much as I.
I do. I love the God who gave it, and the reason it was given. But it isn't love with you, Joseph. You don't love the law. You need it. Sometimes I think that is all you measure your life by. That and your father's judgment. Don't you grow weary of feeling you never measure up?
The law is all we've been given in this world. That is why these men must be stopped. Let Nicodemus wait for signs, and as he always does, I must act. I will follow this man from Nazareth they were calling him Jesus. I will catch him in a transgression, trap him if I must. Sooner or later, he will break the law, and then the law will break him. And then we will see who really acts the truth.
But there must be something more than what you're telling me, Nicodemus. Don't you realize who you're saying this man might be?
Of course I realize.
Then what are we to do?
I don't know. Joseph has made up his mind already, as he always does. I just don't know. Baptism, the water and fire. One runs through your fingers, the other disappears in snow. Then what are you left with? Empty hands.
Open hands. Wait. Let's go finish the meal.
Truma.
Leah?
Yeah?
Yes.
All is on the prayer.
unreliable, always breaking promises. That is why it is so important to hold on to things that do not change. That is why I must make sure things do not change. It has been 1 year since that bazaar at the river. Another Passover. The baptizer has been thrown into prison by Herod. Unusual circumstances create unusual allies. But the one who was baptized, the real criminal, this Jesus of Nazareth, continues to prowl the countryside. I must confess, I have never been so disturbed by someone before. I have been completely clear as to what is right and wrong in this life, but here is a man who disregards the law.
No, working on the Sabbath, I saw him.
Breaks it at every turn.
They say lame men stand in prayer in the palace.
And not only does God allow him to go unpunished, but he seems surrounded by goodwill. His favor with the people grows daily.
It is time for more than just questions.
I have been only watching, but now I'm going to.
So we must act, Joseph. Are you still content to only ask questions?
No. Not after yesterday. It's decided.
Yesterday, what a battleground. Cleansing of the temple, he called it. But you couldn't even see these steps for the debris.
It's not what he did at the temple, it's what he said about it.
Oh, I heard it too. He said he would destroy the temple and then in 3 days raise it up again.
Oh, he will destroy the temple. And everything it represents, including us. No, now I know he must be stopped. I'll set up the circumstances. With all the thieves, murders, and prostitutes in Jerusalem, it shouldn't prove too difficult. It'll take too long.
I'm glad to see that you recognize this apostle for who he is. From some of your remarks recently before the council, I was beginning to wonder if you hadn't joined Nicodemus in his sympathy for the Nazarene.
No, I doubt I can join Nicodemus on anything. No, my questions were merely exploratory.
Nicodemus is just overly anxious concerning the Messiah. His sympathies aren't serious, they're merely sentimental.
And where is he tonight? It's long past sundown. He never misses an evening prayer.
I mean, he said he had a meeting.
That night.
He said to begin with that, and he's uncertain how long it would take.
And the wind blows where it wishes. Though you can hear the sound of it, you'll know where it goes, where it's coming from. Oh, Jehovah, help me know. The wind blows, and you don't know where it comes from or where it goes. You only know the wind blows. A little dark room, we spoke so briefly, but I know that this Jesus has come from God as a teacher. Yet I've been a teacher of Israel all my life. Why do I not understand these things I've heard tonight? He said, there is a kingdom not of this earth. If you would enter, there must be a birth. The fire and water, the spirit within. He said, you must be born again.
How can a man be born when he is already old?
Only a few years are given as yours. Once they've been squandered, you're not given more. Cannot go back to offer amends. You cannot begin again.
Where these things be?
And the wind blows. Jesus said, the wind blows. Nothing forever, God help me decide.
Say what is
And in the law, Moses commands us to stone such women.
Yes! We are to stone her!
What then do you say?
When he is among you without sin, let him cast the first stone.
Thank you.
This is a matter greater than simply carrying out the law.
Nothing was greater than the law. Joseph, what is happening to you? These past months, you become a stranger. No one used to make firm decisions concerning the law. And now you question everything, even this false prophet.
I thought you felt I was too regimented by the law.
At times, perhaps that is true, but you never question the law. Its veracity is placed in our lives. How can you stand by if this man slowly destroys it every time he speaks? Joseph, his fathers believe him to be the son of God.
The son of God?
Yes. Please act. So many are depending on him.
The son of God?
Roma, what are you doing here?
I saw the crowds, Nicodemus. This poor girl is hurt.
Forgive me, Sir Albert. I'll get your coat.
No, no. Thank you, stay put. Nicodemus, she has no home. A roof, baby, but no home.
What's your name, woman?
Tamar.
I've asked her to come live with us.
You've done what? Roma, you know my position. How could you even consider such a thing? Now, I've accepted many things recently that I never thought I would, but I'm not sure I can bend that far. You allow her to come into our home, then I'm not sure I can stay. This woman is...
She's forgiven. I will take her in. It is what Jesus would do, and it's what I must do as well.
What you must do? What are you saying?
That I'm a follower? Yes. I have been for several months. You're home so seldom, I couldn't expect you to notice the change.
Of course I noticed. Change. That's all there is to change.
Well, when will you be coming home?
I'm not sure.
You always said some things would never change, Joseph. And I believe you. I know I will never change. You will have to answer for yourself.
And this That won't be necessary. I was afraid this would.
Are you finished?
Yes, I'm finished.
It's been a difficult day. Indeed, a day for prayers.
Yes.
His followers are a passionate group. Seem unconcerned with the consequences that could befall them for believing his claims.
They were very old.
Joseph, what we saw, a man forgiven sin,
I
heard us punishable by death.
Well, I don't insult him.
But seeing what Jesus does, you fit what he says. Do you ever wonder if it could be true?
No. How could I? How could you? Or have you begun to believe that?
No. It's just the confusion of the day. I've seen too many self-proclaiming messiahs come and go. This Jesus will too.
It seems certain, doesn't it? His enemies are as passionate as his followers in greater number.
And growing every day. Why, the streets of Jerusalem are filled with skirmishes between his defenders and detractors. It's almost as if we forgot that our battle is with the Romans.
Perhaps you should mention Jerusalem in your prayers. Mention all of us.
Yes,
I will. Maybe it was the voices outside the temple that screwed the prayers. Or maybe it was the voices inside the temple. But for whatever reason, Jerusalem became angrier and noisier and more vindictive as the months rushed by. False testimony, misquoted teachings, rumors, lies, they all drew Jesus closer to the deadly snare that waited for him here. But whether he was being worshipped or vilified, my voice never joined the crowds. I stood alone in the shadows, silent, uncertain, unworthy, just like my father always said.
It's been a year. Another Passover approaches.
I'm still standing in the shadows.
I'm still standing on the edge, along the roadside outside of Jerusalem.
My head uncovered.
Watching as others raise their voice, but only to hail him as the king they hoped he would be.
Hey!
Thomas now seem to have the final word.
Tonight again, I stand on the edge, watching as Passover came.
Standing in the shadows, watching as Jesus was arrested like a common criminal.
Watching as he stood before us in the council, one last time.
Now he joined us in our silence.
No, Caiaphas! He clearly said that he would destroy the temple and then in 3 days raise it up again. Those were his exact words, weren't they, Joseph?
His exact words!
Do you not hear these charges against you? Have you no answer? Nicodemus, what happened that day when the adulterers brought it to the temple?
I'll answer for him. The Nazarene refused to carry out the law.
He claimed to be greater than the temple. And what have you to say concerning all this? Answer me! Are you the Christ, the Son of God?
I am.
Thank you.
Jonathan. Are you his mother?
Yes.
I've come to help. My name is Nicodemus, and I am... I'm not sure what I am.
Are you a follower of my son?
Yes. Yes, I am a follower. I can make burial arrangements. I will see that great care is taken.
Burial arrangements have already been. A young man, a follower of the deceased, came to Governor Pilot a short time ago. He offered a new stone tomb somebody could use. He said it was from his family. Governor Pilot gave him permission to take care of the body. You wish to offer these arrangements?
Joseph, are you the follower?
Yes.
So am I.
Carry the body slowly down the hill, away from the place of bones and sorrows, away to a quiet place in the garden, and a new tomb.
A new tomb. My father's final testament. How sad that all he left in his life was a place of death. It used to be my possession of greatest value. But how willingly I gave it up to the one who taught us that our treasure is not in this life, but the one beyond.
They place the body in the tomb and roll the last stone before the entrance. It all seems so final, so silent and final.
And then we pray. For the rest of that day we pray, not in the dark walls of the temple, but there, in the fading light of the garden. And then we returned to the Jordan River for 2 days. We went to the waters to find what we could not see the first time. Hope.
Ask God to make this way clear to my dear brother Joseph.
I pray that Nicodemus would know what to do.
I knew eventually we would return.
We must return
home.
Joseph.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to startle you.
You've been gone without a word for almost 4 days. I started to believe you weren't coming back.
Well, of course not. Is that why you're packing?
No.
Sorry, Tamar. I didn't mean to frighten you. I didn't expect to see you here. I expected to find Ruma.
I'm sorry, sir. I haven't seen you for so long. I can quickly gather my things and find another place to...
No, stop. This is your home. I'm sorry for the things I said at the temple that day, the way I behaved, and for all this time I've stayed away. Arrogance and pride are habits that die slowly.
No. Your words were true that day. I was guilty of the sin for which I was accused. I deserve that punishment.
As we all do. None of us deserve forgiveness. Yet you did. I can do no less. This home has been in my daughter's young voice for too long.
I had guessed all that, Joseph. That you had become a father.
Yeah? How?
You missed the Passover meal. And you left your prayer shawl at home. And the next thing I knew, all I was hearing about was that the false prophet who had been crucified had been buried in a stone tomb, even by a wealthy and honest donor. I was wrong about one thing. You're not like your father at all.
Leah, don't leave! Please, I'm certain that you will come to Joni. You'll come to know Jesus as I have. It took me 2 years, but it will be quicker for you. Your heart's so much more tender.
No, not anymore. I've learned to make my heart very strong. Like the stone in your tomb. I still love the law. But I know you love something else now, and I'm not sure we even love each other anymore.
I still love the law, too. It's just that my law is fulfilled.
I think I am content to wait for mine. I'm going to visit my mother in Capernaum for a while. I haven't seen her for so long. I will be content to wait.
As will I. And so will he.
Goodbye, Jim.
Forgive me, sir. Are you the Pharisee from Aaron and Thea Joseph?
Yes, soldier. What is it?
My captain sent me to find you. I understand you recently gave a tomb to be used for official Rome affair of state. Well, it's been vacated. What do you wish done with it?
It's been what?
Thank you.
must we stand firm. We must go forward. Remember what Jesus has told us? The world is going to hate us, even as it hated him. But we must be strong. He has conquered death. He has overcome the world. He has not taken us out of the world, but sent us into it. And we must have the confidence that if we confess Jesus to others, he will confess us to his Father. And no one, after putting his hand to the plow and looking back, will be fit for his kingdom. He is alive. He is with us.
And in his power we can do all things.
Thank you.